Chihuahua.
You want to know about Iguana Tours? You know a lot already, but a lot of it remains shrouded in mystery. Where should we start? Oh wait, the beginning. That would make sense. Alright, so start off real simple. We want to do something that was out of the ordinary, and something we've never seen before. You know, it wasn't your usual field day, your usual karaoke type stuff. So the day we had to plan for was meme day. So we decided, like, all right, people can dress up as memes. We got to keep the meminess going all day. So we start brainstorming. James Bentayou and a group of us. We start brainstorming. I think someone came up with, like, sort of a maze idea. Then Mr. Hall comes by and says, "What about a Dean Maze maze?" So boom, you know, ideas start flying. People start putting a pitch together. James has the perfect pitch.
Basically, last year there was the idea to build a Dean Maze maze. And this could very well be one of the best ideas ever to come out of student government. Basically what it was is we were going to build a regular maze, but we were going to have thousands of pictures of Dean Maze's face all over the maze. We were going to play switching lanes on the speaker while you like walk through the maze. So you'd be walking through, "I'm switching lanes, skirt, yeah, she met." We were going to do that. We were going to have Dean Maze in the actual maze. If he catches you, you would have to restart the maze. And if you get through the maze, you get like a free dress down day or something kind of cool like that. Yeah, the Dean Maze maze. It was it.
Patrick worked so hard to try and make this happen. When we found out that the big black boards that they typically use for art shows wouldn't work, Patrick moved on to pipe and drape and got rid of the pictures of Dean Maze's face entirely and just focused it on having the deans in the maze and having IDs on the pipe and drape and just decorations all over.
You know, doing the impossible projects are so much more fun than doing like projects that you know you can do. You know, you're like, "Can this actually work? Can I actually do this?" That's where the fun is. And even this was a big challenge. I mean, it was really tough. I started putting the blueprints together for the maze, and we reserved the gym.
So Patrick figures out that the pipe and drape won't work, so he moves on to bushes. And he wants to bring in bushes in pots into the middle school gym.
So I talked to this nursery, and I was like, okay. The final blueprint said we needed 190 bushes, shrubberies. So I texted, I said, "We need 190 bushes." They text back and say, "We have 25 bushes." So, you know, that was a devastating blow to the Dean Maze maze. Probably put it out of commission. We realized it wouldn't get done in the next month, 2 weeks, so we shelved it. So I stumbled onto this video of this really very passionate, very real family playing this floating golf game. So I start brainstorming an idea. I go into student government the pitch.
He finally comes up with this idea for hydro golf, which that again was okay, interesting. We've never done anything like this, but it can work. Let's see if it can work.
So we create a structure with PVC pipes and noodles, pool noodles, around keeping the structure afloat. We put that in the middle of the lake. You have people start chipping golf balls. If you made it, you get a free homecoming ticket. So on top of that, we'd have like fake grass, big pin. It was, for a backup idea, it wasn't that bad.
It honestly turned out a lot better than I anticipated it to. I was there the day before homecoming week started, that Sunday. We were putting the platform together. We put it in the lake. Mr. Harry's had his paddle board and he paddled it out there.
So we set up shop blasting Wii Sports golf music. And, you know, people had a blast. People were chipping. People were close. Ended up no hole in ones. But, yeah, we shelved the Dean Mays maze after that year. I was like, okay, next year, going at this one. October rolls around, and I'm still set on this Dean Mays maze idea. I mean, like, we had planned for October 31st this next year. I'm making a sort of haunted house, Dean Mays, and Dean Watts would walk around, you know, like, in like a spooky haunted house, haunted maze, with like IT belts and IDs hanging. Stuff of nightmares for North Broward kids. But at that point, I had like exhausted all my options, and I was just looking for like a more plausible idea for a homecoming event. So at this point in time, everyone in North Broward has iguana fever. I mean, there's this guy named Caribus by the edge of the lake near around lunchtime, petting iguanas, picking up iguanas. I mean, he was like our Steve Irwin. He was our Bear Grylls. He was like our big nature guy. So everyone was fascinated by him. So I was like, is there a way to capitalize on this iguana craze, making it some sort of like homecoming event? So I started brainstorming, and I put it together, and I was like, all right, what if we did like a jungle cruise sort of tour? Like nature and North Broward Prep. Crack a couple jokes along the way, make it a fun time. So I bring in a student government, I pitch it as like this iguana tour, it's like immersive tour through nature and stuff like that. People think I'm joking, because I'm usually joking a lot, but I was like, all right, you know what, I'm just going to put a blueprint out, I'm going to start repping this, try to get it passed. So I started throwing some ideas of some of my people's student government. I'm like, all right, so a walking tour, that's out of the question. It's going to be like a hot October day, and no one's going to want to rock around. Especially the whole campus. All right, so then we wanted like a flatbed with like chairs to get like, or like one of those big Disney tramps, like to take you from the parking lot to like the park. It's one of those sort of things. We looked that up, that's really expensive. So then we look around, we're like, all right, we have a bunch of golf carts on campus, a couple six-seaters, four-seaters. What if we asked them, we could use that on our tour, make it a whole big thing. So to put this thing together, we needed to get three teachers for each of the three different lunch periods, and I put a guide in each of the ride vehicles with the teachers. And we need to figure out a path and what would actually go down on this ride. So I'm thinking the classic Disney Universal rides, you know. You start off somewhere, something goes wrong, and then you have to get back to where you started from. Definitely a Jurassic Park kind of vibe. So we started putting together a basic script. I let my guides know that they can do whatever they want with the script. It's just like a basic script. You know what's going on. Keep the story going. Crack your own jokes. Do what you want. I mean, it's good so far, but what could really make this pop? Really, I think, get people seeing something they didn't think they would see or have an experience they didn't think they would have. So I talked to Christian Doler, and I'm like, what if we had someone chase down the golf cart? Some sort of like animal type person chase down this golf cart. So we start looking at some costumes. And we hit the inflatable dinosaur costume, and I mean, we knew that was the one. So we reserve the carts, we email them, and then we get them reserved. We get the ELC camp card, six, we get the one admissions card, and we get a card that we're gonna bring out from outside of the campus. You know, on one condition, teachers or admin have to drive the carts, which makes sense. You know, we don't want kids driving this thing. So we set up a group of teachers together that wanted to do it, and we set up a schedule. So we map the path, we're deciding where this thing should go. Once we decide on like a nature tour theme, I knew we had to go to the back lake. There's a second lake behind the residential village, and people don't know it, but there's a lot of iguanas and birds back there. It'd be cool seeing like a side of campus you don't see every day, so I definitely wanted to bring us back there. Your cart would sort of break down behind the residential village, and you stop at like the shady spot. Then we wanted to have something pop out with like a jump scare. What if we had a king iguana? Someone with like an iguana head pop out and scare you. So you start your golf cart up again just in time, getting away from the king iguana as he chases you down. So we had our full track outline now, and now it's just a matter of getting the information to the drivers of the golf carts and getting a script finalized for the tour guides. And we were going all in on this. And definitely the teachers took it super serious too.
Do I remember how it started? You know, we were so young back then, in the fall 2019. Patrick came skipping up to me, a glint in his eye, asking if I wanted to help him in this journey to bring the joy of iguana watching to others. And I can't say no to him.
You know, you think you know a place until you start driving around at night and hearing the noises. We didn't do that, so I guess we don't really know the place, but the Iguana Tour was something else.
we realized that if we were going to make really model this off like a Disney ride, we're going to have to pull out all the stops. So, you know, like a line for the ride, like a queue. Queue. See, queue makes it sound official. Lines like, you know, whatever. Make it a queue. Make it immersive. You know, you get a ride safety video. We get a boarding station for the ride. You know, we get fast passes. Actually, no. Not fast passes. Not yet, anyway.
I think there's this misconception that the Iguana Tour was a spur-of-moment idea, but it really required months of planning. We had to go into school many weekends to make sure that the ride was able to be performed the safest way. Now, I think one thing that we certainly did was we filmed the safety video around the campus, which was important in order to make sure that people were able to board the ride safely and get off at the same time safely.
When boarding the ride vehicle, please watch your head. Make sure to store any loose items like hats below your seat. This is a high-speed roller coaster type ride experience. If pregnant or prone to motion sickness, please refrain from riding. Please make sure to keep your hands and arms inside the vehicle at all times, and remember to collect your belongings on the way out.
Another thing that we had to take account for is the fact that you would be chased by iguanas and dinosaurs while on the ride. So that was an important step for us to make sure that all of our facilities were working properly in order to make sure the experience was the most pleasurable and safe for everyone involved.
Yeah, so Tyler, Drew, and I came in on the weekend and filmed parts of this ride safety video. Originally, it was supposed to have a lot more Carabas in it, the iguana kid.
I'm here with my young friend, Carabas, and I'm going to ask him a couple questions about the Iguana Tour. Now, Carabas, what do you think about the new Iguana Sightseeing Tour?
The iguanas are scared of people, and when people attack them, they run away, and they don't like to interact with most of people.
He's supposed to warn us about like the dangers of messing with the nature, and iguanas specifically, and we ended up going with like a different storyline for the ride safety video. So after we shot that, we just needed to film the golf cart path and give it to the teachers so they knew generally where they were going in their golf carts. So we got hold of the golf cart to use that Sunday, so Tyler and I videoed the course no problem. Then on our way back, it kind of got crazy.
Right as we were getting done with our course, going through the entire thing, we got to the very end, and we noticed that something pretty serious has happened. The golf cart died. The golf cart runs on a battery, and I think the battery had died on the football field, and slowly we started going slower and slower and slower.
We're going to die. We're going to kill this thing.
What a beautiful sunset. Oh my god, it's good.
Did we kill this thing?
Oh god. It's bad.
Until the golf cart totally stopped in the middle of the track on the football field.
It stopped.
We stopped it, and one of us had to steer, and the other of us, Patrick, had to push.
Do not stop pushing. Let's go, Pat!
Of course, I'm the one pushing the cart and Tyler's steering, you know.
But then we had to get it back to the pushling house, which is by Lakeside. It's on the other side of the road by Lakeside. We had to push it around. We had to push around half a mile.
One of the security guards actually ended up helping us push it back to where it was before the golf cart. So thank you, Mr. Security Guard, if you're watching this program. Definitely a wild day in the world of Iguana Tours and the big, vast history of it.
All right, guys, welcome to the NBPS Nature Preserve.
People had no idea what to expect. We just wrote Iguana Tours on our homecoming event signs list, and it just kind of a nice touch because it got people's attention. They're like, what is Iguana Tour? I don't know what that is. So people came to lunch, looked for an Iguana Tour, and then that first lunch, after the first 10 minutes, there must have been like a 20-minute line for Iguana Tours. And second lunch must have been like 30 minutes.
He was planning on hundreds of riders and how we'd fit them all in the carts and everything. And I'm sitting here thinking, there's no way we get more than 50 people. I was wrong. We filled capacity all three lunches and people were super excited about it. And it ended up being just an amazing experience.
I was lucky enough to experience the Iguana Tours this year. I was a driver for third period lunch, and it was just an action-packed event. It was so much fun and so exhilarating to drive and seeing students' reactions to what the student government had planned. It was just really, really cool and so funny and so much fun. when you jump on and you hear the announcements, like you're at Disney World.
If any of you folks are wearing hats or glasses, just remove them, because this here's the wildest ride in the wilderness! Para su seguridad.
And then you get, you actually get on the tour and, you know, the pre-planned jokes.
On your right, you're going to see one of our natural geysers.
And just some of the experiences, the T-Rex was just perfect. And then, you know, the history lesson of what's going on in the park. And then when you get to the second part of the Iguana Tour and there's another monster, it's just so cool.
It was crazy. People were loving Iguana Tours. All our drivers and guides did a fantastic job. I think Christian Doler definitely stole the show, by far. I don't know how he survived in that suit for like 3 hours in the afternoon.
How bad was I sweating? Well, I was wearing a roll of dino, zipped up with no holes, wearing black underneath, on a hot 90 degree weather day. So you tell me, did I enjoy being the dino? That's a complicated question, because on one hand, I love popping out and scaring the living daylights out of people. It's a blast. However, when the golf carts came in quickly, I was working double time and I was going crazy. However, after I got popcorn, chicken, water, and Gatorade, so it was worth it.
And Ben Meyer, the kid in the iguana head, originally did a fantastic job. He would like pop out of the literal box, like you'd crawl inside the cardboard box and pop out. And people would freak out, like, what is happening? But he almost passed out. Thank God he didn't. But thanks to Justin for stepping out the last second, last notice to give Ben a much needed break. He also did a fantastic job.
Serving as the iguana was definitely one of the most memorable highlights of my year and a favorite for many students for sure. Just watching the pure joy on their faces was what made this event so special for our committee. These events are solely for the students, and they are the reason why we run them.
Let me try the boat.
So within Iguana Tours, I was originally supposed to just be loading people up, but then I ended up being a tour guide somehow, and it was a really cool experience. It was kind of just like a go with the flow type vibe.
Being a driver was so much fun. We just played with the script, talking about the random animals we saw. My favorite part was, you know, it was timed up with the Jurassic Park music, so when you turn that corner going into the back lake, you got that kind of view. That kind of moment the guys from Jurassic Park did when they're like looking at the dinosaurs for the first time. It was pretty nice. It was a pretty nice touch. Each ride was really its own unique experience.
The most awkward thing. Well, I say the most awkward thing was about halfway through second lunch. Throughout the day, we'd be seeing about like 3 or 4 iguanas pretty much in the past few tours. And all of a sudden, all at once, all the iguanas disappeared. Like completely. We couldn't see one on the tour except for the one that we had dressed up. So it was kind of awkward explaining why there was no iguanas left for anyone to see, and we had to think of things to fill time, but we got past it and ended up still having a great time. I'd say iguana tours are something that is just unique to the North Broward culture. I mean, at what other school will you have administrators driving kids on golf carts as someone gives a tour of the wildlife of the school as a Spirit Week activity? I mean, you'd never think about that unless you're really part of the North Broward culture and you can feel like you're immersed into it.
Overall, though, what I loved most about it was just how the community of kids really just enjoyed it and they just had a pleasant time. So my hat's off to student government for planning it and really just finding ways to not take yourselves too seriously and have fun for each other, for the students on campus, and also the faculty.
Yeah, Iguana Tours was definitely a first of its kind thing that NBP had never seen before. It'll definitely be remembered, something I'll never forget, creating and, you know, building this Iguana Tour universe. I couldn't have done it without my friends and student government and teachers involved. It was really a joint effort from everybody.
Hope it's something that future classes can find a way to continue, but they'll certainly have big shoes to fill.
It should be a great time. Have a good one. Wait, what is that? Oh my God! Oh my God! Oh, you're doing this!
We're done? Okay. I can take this off.